Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And today I would be showing you how to make this stunning, amazing, fantastic dashboard. This dashboard can analyze passengers by city, by airports, by country, and by the date of the month. To start with, you need to watch the part 1, which will explain you how to download the data, how to download Tableau Public, and how to make that amazing visualization. And if you have already watched the part 1, so let's get started. Now let's create the part 2 of the visualizations. To create the part 2 of the visualization, what we need is we need to add some more KPIs into our dashboard, which can make immersive experience for the audience. What we're going to do is we're going to take the destination country names. We're going to put it on the map, change it to map filled. We're going to change the map's background to dark. We're also going to change the color according to the passenger. Finally, I will go on colors and added this colors. I will choose the green and gold color, apply, click on OK, which is basically has become our theme of Tableau. Now, once this sheet is completed, I will call it as country map. Let's create the next page. We want the destination name. However, if your destination is showing as a string, please click on the arrow button and change the geographical role to city. Click on the destination name and we want to see how many sum of passengers were into the city. Lastly, I again want to change the color, so I will format the whole field. Once the formatting is completed, I want to add text. I want to show number of passengers and also the destination code, or instead of destination code, I want to show country name. But as you can see, the text together seems congested and therefore I will do a dual axis. And let it be bars, but I will put the destination in one and the sum of passengers in another. It will do is it, I'm able to format it more easily. Where does my country go? As you can see, there's a difference in the values of the bar. To make this difference equal, we need to synchronize the axes. Once the axes are synchronized, all we need to do is find where our text is. Okay, that's better. Perfect. Okay, we can see it now. At the bottom of these charts, most of them are overlapping. To remove this overlapping, all we need to do is click on Edit Axis and click on Logarithmic. And please exclude 0. Call it as a bar chart of passengers. a density chart with the departure date. So I have departure dates by, let's say, by month, and we're gonna put our passengers, the sum of passengers. It creates this lovely trend on how many passengers have traveled in which month. I'll change the worksheet back to black, remove our grid lines, and lastly I will change the color. I will also change the color of the sum of passengers to green, and I will increase the size a little bit. And instead of this line, I will choose the density. Change the color to green and gold. Density high and opacity a little less. Lastly, I want the destination country name in as details and sum of passengers as text. To improve the looks, I will change the font to 6. And now it's time to create a new dashboard. Similarly, we'll change the sheet size to automatic, and we'll put all the pages inside this dashboard. I will hide all the titles. And use the country as the filter. Finally, I will add a title to the dashboard. And I will format the title, make it black. At the end, I want to remove all the legends and let's visualize. I think this dashboard is not showing all the data. To show all the data, I will go on the sheet and remove the filters. Now, simply to filter the dashboard, all I'm gonna do is click on any of the country, for example, Portugal. In the destination of Portugal, which airport was in high in demand, and I can also see in which month there was how many customers were there. Let's find out in Spain. So in the Spain, we can clearly see that in the month of October, there was the highest number of passengers who have traveled, and these were the airports. Now it looks so amazing. Next, what I want to do in this dashboard, I want to add more details into the dashboard. So first of all, I'm gonna add a date filter. I'm gonna use this filter to filter out all the sheets. Lastly, I'm gonna add some text. For example, I want to know total number of passengers. And to know total number of passengers, I will just add it as a simple text. Name the sheet as total passengers. Change the color to red, apply, and size 9. But before formatting, I want to see if it is able to change. I think I will also add the sum of passengers. Let's also add the destination country name. Now, similar to total passengers, we also want to create which is called the percentage of passengers, right? To do so, we would be needing to create a calculating field which is called percentage of passengers, which would be the sum of passengers divided by max of we will use level of details, so max of sum of passengers. So once the percentage of passengers is done, all we need to do is, as you can see, it's an decimal number. We need to change this decimal to percentage, and to do so, all we need to do is just right click on it, go on calculation field, and just click on percentages. There we go. And we're going to use the sheet, the percentage of passengers, into our dashboard. Simply going to put the percentage of passengers over here. We're gonna make it as a floating type. Once it is floating type, we're gonna choose and basically we are following the same steps as we did for the total passengers. I'm gonna right click and format and change the background color to black. Lastly, I want to change the color of the field to a green. And now the idea behind this total percentage of passengers is that to know that at this destination, what was the percentage of passengers who visited? So out of 100%, 40% of people actually visited Spain. France was visited by 1.5% only, and those total passengers were who visited France were 6,800. I think instead of total passengers, we should call those passengers. Not the Netflix series, but the actual passengers. Also, this is really, I find this really interesting because in airlines, it is very important to know a trend. For example, let's say every country, some countries might have some type of a trend where specific, in a specific month, people go or they go highly. So that's why we have created this visualization. So for example, here in Greece, people do not visit in winters, or in Bulgaria also people do not visit in winters, and they usually go into the summer time. Lastly, this visualization is pretty simple. It's just showing us the destination and the number of passengers who have visited, and by the country. So this is the end. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please click on like and subscribe button to get some more of, which will motivate me to make some more amazing dashboards, and stay connected because I would be posting more of these dashboards. See you again soon.